yourself, what do I mean, sir? If a man doesn't has forgotten his name, he's a sick man. They call that amnesia.
Hey, what's going on, guys? Hello, happy Friday afternoon. What's going on? Let me know how everything's looking, sounding. Something seems strange. I feel like I'm forgetting something. I don't think so, but let me also make a little adjustment here. No, all right. Audio is good. What's up, Mercenary? Revan, Geek Eric, what's going on, guys? Some familiar faces here right off the bat. Glad you guys can be here. As often, if not always, always, if not often. Yes. Mr. Gorehammer as well. Damn, I'm looking at my... Okay, so you guys may have seen the video yesterday. Taking a look at this lovely lady here, the Asura Ninja figure statue from Kotobukiya, and I'm just remembering that I meant to show that this morning on the live stream. So Adam and I were live on the USA Gundam TV channel this morning, and I was going to show that, and I forgot. Darn. Okay. Robert here as well. Quality of life? Poor. Sorry. Quality of life here is fine. So, doing good? Question mark. Robert asked. Hey. Hey, Robert. Yes. Doing pretty good. Yeah. Pretty good day today. Just finished. I wasn't planning on having any video to upload, aside from this live stream. I wasn't planning on having any video to upload either today or through the weekend. But in the time between this morning's live stream on the USA Gundam TV channel and this live stream, I decided, oh, it's kind of enough time to either just kind of work on just building a kit for a little while, or I can make a video if it's something that I can do in a relatively short amount of time. So I thought, I've got a big and growing stack of different MOOCs, books, and magazines and stuff that I want to review and share with you guys. So I thought, why don't I just do a quick video just kind of going through one of those. And those are always nice to put out, I think, like during the weekend, because I like to put those kind of videos, the MOOC review videos, out during the weekend, so that hopefully for you guys to watch it, while you're just kind of chilling out over the weekend. It's just like a very chill type of video, just basically kind of like flipping through a hobby magazine. So that's what I did. So I got that finished editing. So as soon as we're done with the live stream, I'll upload that, and then I'll set that to go live probably tomorrow morning. So this weekend, you guys can look forward to a MOOC review video, if you look forward to those videos, if you like those type of videos. But those will be going up. Matthew also said, good morning, good afternoon. Afternoon here, but yes, good morning, afternoon to wherever you guys are. Real quick, which one do you guys want to see built first? Let me know in the comments. You want to see Dougram or Brutishdog first? You can let me know. While I'm saying some other hellos here. Is it Stephanie? Just with an E? It looks like Stephanie to me, but I'm not sure. The reading of that. Said, hey, DeadSec, hello. See, I see a couple early votes there for Dougram. Let's see. This morning, Aletta Sky of Agency Kawaii started building her HG Aerial Gundam, spent most of the wee hours of the morning watching her figure stuff out. Interesting. I don't know who that is, but I'm guessing that's like a Japanese VTuber or something. Let's see. Rick said, hey, y'all. Let's see. What's your wife's opinion of her? Oh, Revan. My wife has not seen the statue yet, but she generally doesn't care too much about stuff like that. So I think she would probably... Let's see. I'm seeing a lot of votes for Dougram, so I guess Dougram's going to be first. Put a poll in the chat. I'm not sure if I can do that. At least not on StreamYard, where I'm managing this. I'm not sure if I switched Aletta is a British VTuber. Oh, okay. Not Japanese. But... let me see if I'm actually on YouTube, if I'm monitoring the stream on YouTube. Can I put a poll in the chat? Anyway, I think the poll is already well enough decided. I saw like 10 votes for the Dougram and like one for the Brutishdog. So let me go here because actually I need to check on something here real quick before we get started. And I can do this. And let's see. Control room. Poll. Oh, I can start a poll. Dougram, Brutishdog. Which to build first? Okay. There you go. All right. So there's the poll up on YouTube. That's cool. Didn't know that I could do that. But yeah, the Dougram, I was already seeing lots of votes for the Dougram, so I'll put that there. Actually, that's this one. Okay. And yeah, Dougram. Looks like you guys all want to see. The Dougram is actually the easier of the two kits, as in like the fewer parts. Both of them are pretty simple, so that's why if you guys were wondering like, hey, how can... It's 3 o'clock there, and you need to be done by 5 o'clock. How are you going to finish two kits in 2 hours? These kits are pretty simple, both of them. The Dougram especially. If you guys saw my review of the previous Dougram Get Truth kit from Max Factory, I talked about in that video how the kit was very similar to an entry grade kit. It's basically like an entry grade Dougram, just not entry grade because not from Bandai, but very, very similar just in terms of the overall construction of it. And that's just because, yeah, it's just really simple. Not a lot of parts, but despite its simplicity, it is still nice. Let me just check this here. There we go. I feel like these kits are also a little bit small, so I figure I'll zoom in a little bit more. And okay. But yeah, both of these kits are pretty simple. Neither of which should take all that long to put together. The Brutishdog might take a little bit more because that one might require a little bit of glue. You don't really need to glue anything on that from my experience building the Scope Dog set from Wave previously. I didn't, as far as I can remember, I don't think I had to glue anything, like just as far as the being able to get the kits through review anyway. Once actually like painting the kits and everything, there's definitely parts that I would want to glue, but at least to put them together and be able to do the review and everything, even though there was definitely a few kind of janky parts here and there, it would be a good idea to glue some of that stuff. But anyway, so there we go, there's the head for the Dougram. And so yeah, a lot of really nice detail in there, and you have the pilot seated inside here and everything. But I mean, you get a lot of nice detail out of very few parts, and also some pretty decent articulation. So we'll get to that in a moment. Revan asked, have you tried the Motorized Mole Car, Zach? Yes, I have, but not on YouTube, obviously. For Christmas, I got a couple of the mole cars for my kids for Christmas. I got them one each of the mole car. I thought about like if I should make a video out of that or anything like that. And maybe, I don't know, if you guys would like to see a review of the mole car kits from... that's also from Max Factory, right? Yeah, if you guys would like to see a review of the mole car kits, let me know. Maybe I'll grab another one and do a quick review of it. But I mean, they're very, very simple, and I feel like that's so niche I don't know. I mean, I don't and the other thing is, you guys know, I like to stick to doing reviews to generally stuff that's like of interest to me personally. And if it's things that, you know, don't interest me that much personally, then I usually don't like to spend time reviewing them. I would rather use my limited time resource towards things that are really interesting. But well, the Mole Car show is quite interesting, just like for the novelty of it. Let's see. And it was fun to build a couple of them with my kids. I mean, I don't know if it's really something that I feel like I really want to spend time covering here on my channel, but if you guys are interested in seeing about the kids, let me know. I can do one that, like I said, they're really quick to build. Maybe, you're not supposed to be there. So here for the torso, let me zoom in here for you guys. So that's it for the torso. So again, super duper simple, hollow on the inside, but just from the outside, I mean, like, nice details, everything, and like a fairly decent color separation for that, just like that. But yeah, nothing fancy by any means. All right, so let's move on to the arms. Actually, are next, but I want to skip ahead to the waist because for some reason I put one of the waist parts in the wrong spot with the torso parts. So since I've got that out, might as well do that right now. Anyone else besides me know of the Gundam Explained YouTube channel? Yes, I believe it's Adam told me about that. I think maybe I've like seen it before, just kind of around in passing. But I believe Adam's a fan. I think I've just seen it in passing, but it's not something that I've like watched much of. If it's available on USA Gundam Store, why not? Riven mentioning about the mole cars. I mean, yeah, we carry them. Yeah, I suppose that just coverage of the mole cars may help people to kind of know that they exist. I mean, some people may not even know that those are even a thing. So I guess so. I see your point. Now that's supposed to be a little bit tighter in there, I feel like. And it will be once I put this part on. This part. This one on the front. There we go. And then these. Let's see. I've seen it. Mr. Gorehammer said, "Seen? You mean you've seen Mole Car? Are we still talking about that, or are you talking about something else?" Sorry. That's the thing. Like, I don't think I would have ever come across Mole Car or ever seen it had I A, not had kids, and B, not like worked for in this industry. Like, if I was just like a normal, just a consumer of plastic models and don't have children, then it's very likely, you know, you just wouldn't know about Mole Car. I mean, maybe you've just kind of seen it for sale on different websites or something, I guess, maybe, but it's fairly obscure. But speaking of obscure kits, I don't want to spoil the surprise, but I just package arrived yesterday, and I just opened it today. Got like probably the most weird and obscure model kit that I've ever had, I would say, probably. So I'm looking forward to making a video on that. And I guess it kind of breaks the rule a bit as to what I was talking about just a second ago about how I like to focus on stuff that's of particular interest to me. This one actually, like not really something that I would really be that much interested in. The main reason why I'm interested in it enough that I wanted to pick it up and I want to make a video out of it is just because it's so obscure. I feel like it's so weird to be made into a model kit. So that was the only reason why I decided to go ahead and get it so I can make a video out of it, just because I feel like otherwise there's no way I would have. And this part, I feel like I put this on backwards. Did I? It's supposed to be... No, that's the front. No? It's right. It's just a little tight. Okay. Ooh. All right. So... Gundam, Mr. Barhammer's talking about Gundam Explained, right? Yeah. No, I haven't never watched it that much, but I know of it. Vaguely. This is supposed to click. But I'm not hearing anything click. And this is also supposed to click. Didn't really do it, but... Not really sure what is supposed to click, because it doesn't like have a little raised section. That did. I guess that was it. Okay. And our hand, which is just a closed fist hand. That's it. So that's the other thing. Aside from this kit just being kind of generally simple in its construction and all that, it's just not going to have much in the way of like accessories or anything really either. It's going to be pretty minimal. How much is USA Gundam's kit for the Witch from Mercury Lefrith Gundam? I've heard great things about its building aesthetics. I mean, yeah, the Lefrith, the great kit. I know that we don't have it right now, and that we did just get some this week, but those immediately just went towards filling some pre-orders. And we've still not filled all the pre-orders, so we still have some more of the kit on the way, and more like pre-orders just to fill before we have any more just in stock that you can just buy. So I'm sure those will be coming soonish, but yeah, we're just waiting on those from Bandai basically. And then once we get the rest from Bandai, and then we're able to... Yeah, that's weird. Oh, shoot. And I just broke that. And I hope that I'm not going to end up breaking the other arm in the process of that, if that's on correctly. And it should be. Let me double check. Because now I just broke that piece. That's annoying. And that's on correctly. That's weird. That's a shame that it's so tight that it would just break like that. All right. Well, interesting. Will you review any more SMP kits? What's SMP? Now I'm drawing a blank as to what you're even talking about. I think before I bent that, I should have plugged the piece onto the back of it. So I'm going to put some glue on this. And I'm going to set it off to the side. I was thinking I might need the glue today just because I might need to glue some parts that aren't snap fit. I didn't think I was going to have to glue something that I broke. But let me just go ahead and grab that. SMP, why does that sound so familiar? But I'm sorry, I'm drawing a blank trying to think of what you're talking about. I think I can go ahead and put this on here. Just for the time being, make it like that. And we're going to leave the arm off for the moment. SMP. Sorry, I'm trying to think of... You're going to let me know there in the chat what's SMP? Because I'm trying to think. The Shokugan modeling project. Yeah, I don't know. What else is there? It's honestly, you're talking about the Gunbuster, right? That I reviewed from that line. I'm not sure what else is even available. So probably not, just because it's not a line of kits that I'm particularly following. And if it's mostly just kind of like super robot type of stuff, then it's not really something that I'm really interested in. Like a Gunbuster I like well enough, but other than that, not really. So I'm gonna set this arm to the side. Sorry about that for the broken piece there. But yes, as for those kits, no, I don't have any... I don't know of what other kits even exist in the line. And as far as I know, it's not wouldn't be very many. But, no. Sorry. Is there a particular one that's out that you would like to see? I don't even know what else is there. A neat series to get into if you want to give Super Robot a second shot is Mazinger and Getter Robo. Yeah, and just not really. I'm actually the one responsible for putting Adam and Stefan of the Midnight Hatter together last year. I don't know what that is either. But all right. The Mazinger is the Infinitism. It is in the Infinitism kits are pretty good. I mean, yeah, the Mazinger kids do look pretty cool. The only one of those that I've built, though, is the huge one. What was the name of it? Of like the scale. I guess it didn't really have a scale or anything assigned to it, right? It was just the huge Mazinger kit. And okay, so similar to the entry grade, as I was saying, you guys can just see like from the parts complexity here, the leg, it's like the knee joint is two parts, the thigh armor is two parts. We do have a couple of parts that are added onto the knee here on the front and back before we get to the lower leg, but that's just because the lower leg is like such that it's quite short and stocky in the legs. Both of these kits are. Both this and the Brutishdog. They both have a kind of very similar aesthetic to them, right? Which is why I thought they would make for a good double build between the two. Quite aesthetically similar, of course. That and, yeah, both relatively simple builds. So... this one goes here on the back of the foot. And... oh, yeah. Right there. Right there. And there we go. That's it for the leg. But again, let me just zoom in here. Yeah, as you guys can see, there's still a lot of really nice detail and stuff on there. And nicely color separated with the red bits and everything. Detail underneath the feet, though, it's just kind of leaves a little bit to be desired there. But so long as you just have it just standing, it's going to look really nice. Yeah. Come on. There you go. It's one side. Adam Blue. Okay, let's see. Adam Blue is the main host for Gundam Explained show on YouTube. Zinger Kids. Yeah. Does the red bit on the heel have articulation? No. That's just fixed in place there, like that. The red bit there on the heel. Extreme close up. Yes. I want you guys to see it very close. More or less, it's like a no grade kit, but with the knowledge of where the pilot is seated. I mean, yeah. It's like a no grade, or I mean, like I said, it's. To me, it seems closest to, like, to compare this to anything from Bandai, it really seems closest to an entry grade. It's got some... It's really simple, just in the way that everything goes together. Where basically, it's making the most out of the fewest parts possible. That's what really kind of sets the entry grade line apart in my mind, where you really only have a very few parts, but you still manage to get pretty nice color separation and articulation. Though I guess with I was gonna say, though, with those parts you get a little bit more in the way of accessories, because they'll have at least like a handheld weapon or something like that, like at least the beam saber or something would be included in there. But really, I mean, this has that, though, just in this has something comparable to that anyway. Just instead of a beam saber in the hand, it's got its weapons like that just connect onto the arm, and then the backpack as well. So it's got its weaponry, it's just not handheld weaponry. So yeah, it really would be quite similar. There's like the number of colors too. We've got 4 or 5 colors in here, so I think that's comparable as well. If I can get this pole joint to pop into place there inside the foot. Hey. I guess that's in there. Seems a bit questionable though. Not sure if that foot's gonna stay on. Nope. The other one went on fine. I don't know what's the deal with this foot, why it doesn't want to pop into place. Let's have a closer look here. Hang on. Yeah, I think I need to push this one in there a little bit more too. There we go. There's nothing like blocking it or anything. Doesn't seem to want to pop in there. I need something to press it. Let's see. I need to be trying to be really careful too, not to make sure I'm not putting pressure on anything that shouldn't be. The other one popped in there super easy. I don't know why this one just doesn't want to go into the socket. There we go. I guess maybe I got it. I guess so. Weird. Yeah. And so, minus the arm, which I'll need to wait until the glue is dried and then I'll put that on there. But aside from that, here's our finished kit, main body of it and everything of it anyway. How do you decide what kind of lines to scribe on a Gundam? Enigmatic asks. I don't really do much scribing, number one, just because I'm not good at it. And number two, it's just not really usually of interest to me to do that. So that's why I just don't really have any motivation to even try to get better at it. I mean, I guess sometimes it would probably be just like a good skill to have, or, you know, just to make my kits look better, I guess, but it's not really something that I often think about, like when I'm making a kit and like trying to customize it in a way to really make it my own. That's not one of the things that I'm usually thinking of, like different ways to go about doing that. But I don't know, I guess I should try to get a bit better at it. To answer your question though, let's see. How to decide what kind of lines to describe when I'm gonna, I mean, basically I would say just look at some different examples and basically just copy what you see people doing essentially. I mean, at least to get you started off, I mean, really just straight up copying might be a good way to just kind of let you kind of get the hang of it. And then once you've kind of gotten better at just the actual physical process, then you can kind of start to get more creative with it, like expressing your own creativity, doing that in you know, your own way. But I don't know, yeah, just copying other custom builds at first might be just a good way to go, just to get started. Oops. Let's see. Could pencil it out and see how it looks. Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. You use a pencil. That's usually kind of the first step that any tutorial really would tell you to do. Yeah, draw it out with a pencil or something first. And there's lots of good books and materials and things out there that you can use. Whole books about scribing. And I mean, obviously, if it's something that you really want to do, I mean, certainly could pick one of those up. But there should be a lot of free resources available for you as well. Just different YouTube videos and things like that. Blogs and anything else that you can find on the subject matter. Or again, just look at different YouTube channels that do do more scribing. Just kind of look at kind of how they're going about it, just in terms of like the speed of their technique, kind of how they're holding the scriber, how they're tracing their lines, how they're masking off different sections. Things like that. So this is just the backpack, and once we finish this, we're done here for the Dougram. Max Factory is a Japanese company, Eric asked. Yes, it's a part of Good Smile Company. Max Factory, Max being Max Watanabe. The originator of appreciating Gunpla. Essentially, as far as I understand, if not like one of the first people to like really make that technique famous. But yes, Max Factory is part of Good Smile Company. There we go. So that's a wrap on that. So the backpack, just straight onto the back here. Make sure those tubes are on the top. There you go, like that. And cannon goes on one side. And missile pod goes on the other side. Like that. And we're all done. So let me zoom out, focus not so extreme close up here for you guys, just so you can see. So yeah, a lot of really great detail on there. And it's definitely going to take, I mean, if you want it to look really, really good, it's going to take a lot of detail painting and weathering and all that kind of stuff. But just as a base kit, just for what it is, I guess the biggest difference between this kit and between this kit and an entry grade is the nice thing of the entry grade line is how cheap they are. This one's definitely going to be more expensive, like for what it is. So, I mean, understandable that difference. But with that, let's move on to the Brutishdog and affordability, or the price, anyway, of the Brutishdog here. Definitely going to be an issue with this kit as well, as I know these Wave Scope Dog kits are quite pricey for what they are, really. I mean, and it's not to say that, like, oh, for such a, like, a bad kit, it's very expensive. They're not bad kits at all. They're quite nice little kits, but I mean, like, compared to Gunpla, at least, like, I can very easily understand why some, for people who normally build like Bandai Gundam HGs and stuff like that, they're used to paying like $15 to $20 for a model kit, to pay like $40 for a model kit, and one that, although not really, but kind of probably, or it would be a good idea to use glue, that it's a snap fit, but you know, it's kind of janky if you just snap fit. It's a better idea to actually have to glue some parts of it. I can understand for a lot of people like that, that they may think that it's just too expensive for them. But I mean, it's all about, you have to know what you're getting yourself into. Just grabbing my tools here, just because I know that there's a part that I left here on the runner for the Brutishdog. That's one of the parts here for the camera on the eye. Quite small kit here too. So this one is very comparable to, I always feel like building the other ones and then build, and then I'm sure I will building this one as well, but like these kits are, let's see, sorry. These kits are comparable to building like a Machining Krieger, except that they are actually all snap fit, whereas Machining Krieger kits are not. You definitely need glue for Machining Krieger kits. You could not glue anything on this, but yeah, you're just not going to have a good time. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Okay, so this part, oops, I missed a little thing here. Yeah, for me, a normal HG varies from $30 to $45 versus MG, which varies from $70 to $120. Yeah, that's pretty expensive. And depending on where you are in the world, the prices will vary. Whereas, like, I'm talking about the price of this kit being expensive, but if you lived in Japan, then it wouldn't be quite so expensive. I think it's still, like, list price 3,000-something yen. Which, yeah, for that amount, basically you can get a real grade, a lot of real grades for less than that, even in Japan. Even some different master grades, stuff like that. Bigger and or more complex models from Bandai, but let's see. Just pop that little tiny piece in there for our lens, and we have a sticker for that as well. Went over there and grabbed tools and didn't grab tweezers. Forgot. Brutishdog is Mega Man-esque. Yeah. I could see that. It's got the cannon arm. Also similar to Samus, I guess, in a way. That. Okay. it's tricky. This little tiny piece here that holds the scope eye kind of camera array in place. It's just a really tiny piece here for that. There you go. So that would be a part that you probably are going to want to glue just because it's such a tiny little connection. I'm going to put a super tiny little bit of glue on that just because I want to be able to take it apart again later whenever I build the kit, probably. Actually, possibly not, but it probably doesn't even matter because if and when I ever get around to painting this kit in particular, it'll probably just be hand painting anyway, so it doesn't really matter if I can separate those parts again, but just in case, I don't want to slather too much glue on that. Also going to want to be very careful with little thin little parts like the antennas on the top of the head there. But that's it for our little dome head. Here you go. Totes adorbs. But again, really nice detail on this. And with this one too, I think we have the same number of colors. So with the Dougram way, we had 5 colors. With this one, we have 5 colors. Yeah, there you go. What scale is this, Lomas? 1/35th scale, I believe. Yeah, 1/35th scale. Actually, I think both of them are. No, the Dougram is 1/72nd scale. It's twice the size. The kit is going to be basically the same size. Oh, no, actually, this is smaller. Yeah, this kit will definitely be smaller than the Dougram. I'll show you a size comparison here in a second. Once it's all done anyway. Make sure I'm keeping an eye on the time, but we should be all good. Let's see. When do you think we will get a new ARC-782 real grade, one with better parts and frame? I'm not sure. I would say if we ever do get any like 2.0 real grade kits, I don't know if they would call it 2.0 or what they would call it. I'm not sure what it would be, but if we ever do get a updated ARC-782 real grade, if we ever get any kind of updated real grade kits, I would say it will be the ARC-782. Yes, so I think you're correct in that assumption, but yeah, I have no idea when that might be, and yeah, if that happens, what exactly will be updated, if it will keep like generally the same design, but just like update how the frame is done. I don't know. Yeah, it's hard to say. I need to build that kit again someday because I always feel like that I built that kit twice, but it was a long time ago, more than maybe not more than, maybe like around 10 years ago. Yeah, it would have been. Yeah, about 10 years ago that I built that kit, and I don't remember having an issue with it. I thought it was fine. But of course I hear about it a lot, like just from people online. The quote unquote early real grade syndrome. And yeah, the only issue that I ever had with the Zaku 2 was that I found the hip joint to be a little weak because I actually broke one of the hip joints on one of the RG Zaku 2s that I built. But other than that, between the ARC-782 and the Zaku 2, I don't feel like either of them are that bad. Yeah, they're not quite as nice as some of the later RGs like that we have now, but not bad anyway. Tough to get that. I have to use my teeth to push this peg into the ball joint here. It's funny, like being a parent, to my kids, whenever they use their teeth for stuff, I always have to remind them, like, don't use your teeth, because, you know, I'm just worried about them. I want them to hurt themselves or hurt their teeth, whatever. But then, like, when I have to do it for, you know, whatever, if I have to use my teeth for something, like, then they're always, they'll like just repeat it back to me. They're like, no, daddy, don't use your teeth. Like, it's okay for me, but not for you. Now, is this correct? Okay. Yeah, like putting this all together, like this torso section here, it just has the feeling of not being super sturdy. And the same thing with the other kit, with both of these kits. They don't have that super sturdy, solid feeling that like you get with like a Bandai kit, right? So it's something to keep in mind. I don't think it's a bad thing by any means, but you know. It serves like as you're putting the kit together, it serves as a good reminder of, as to number one, like how nice Bandai model kits are, how like oh man, never really thought about how sturdy Bandai model kits are when I'm putting them together while building one of these kits. But the other thing is that it's a good reminder that you're building a model kit and not a toy. Whereas with Bandai, I mean, for how nice their kits are, I mean, with the end result, it basically feels like you have like an action figure just as much as it is a plastic model. Yeah. Left out the polycap in there, so I needed to pull that section apart again. Let's see, 24. I think an RX-782 version 2 real grade with some LED lights would be so cool. I mean, that would be tricky, of course, anytime you're talking about putting LED lights into a real grade. Sounds like it's going to be easier said than done. But, I mean, I don't know. If they could figure out a way to do it that worked well. And the only thing, like, the other thing that worries me whenever you bring up Bandai and LED lights is that Bandai, I don't know if it has to do with where they have them manufactured or what, but I don't know. Everything, usually if it's from Bandai and it includes LED lights, then it's just like guaranteed to be that much more expensive. And I guess I should say, like, it's going to be more expensive compared to normal Bandai prices, whereas like because Bandai prices are so cheap like compared to other model kit companies, just because of the size of Bandai, just the scale of their production capacity, the scale of their production capacity is so much that they can price their kits quite cheaply. So Bandai model kits are in general quite cheap, but then when you add LEDs, I mean, the LEDs add a lot in terms of the cost, which then doesn't necessarily make the kits expensive. It then turns them from like being very cheap to just kind of normal model kit prices, I guess. I am gluing this little not rod, bar. This is a bar here on the front. I'm gluing that because although it fits in there fine, it doesn't like stay straight. It's not like a really tight fit. It's a bit loose, so it's kind of like leaning a bit in the wrong direction. So just put some glue on that just to make it straight, basically. Okay. And the hatch for the top. So there is some detail inside. And it's made in a way that you can open it up, but there's no like full-on cockpit or anything inside. It would be cool if they made that, and or if like I haven't seen this, maybe it exists, but if there's like a garage kit for like adding a cockpit and or a pilot even inside one of these Wave 135th scale scope dogs kits. Have any of you guys ever seen that before? I've never seen it. Oops, sorry. Started bouncing my foot and shaking the whole camera. Sorry about that. But yeah, I've never seen a garage kit, like upgrade set for the Wave 135th scale scope dogs, but I would imagine it could very well exist. If not, there's opportunity there for anybody who wants to get on their like 3D printing game or something. The PS version is coming with a cockpit and pilot. Ah, okay. There you go. Subhuman Torch set. I'm not sure if I've seen that. Have I seen that before? Oh, deliveries here. Let me see. Let's see. Wave Scope Dog PS. Let me see. It's a future release, right? Just looking for it here. Future release. No, I'm not seeing it. You could model it and have it printed, yeah. Let's see. Is that from Wave? Or is it from a different company? Scope Dog PS. Oh yeah, Wave. Just looking up some photos here of that. It's on Amazon for $92. Whew. Yeah, same on eBay. Oh, okay, yeah, here I found a picture of the inside of it. Okay, interesting. Rare, it said. Let's see. Let's check that. So it's this one from Wave. Okay. So it's already been out, right? It's not something new. PS Scope Dog has been and gone. Yeah, but the Brutishdog. Oh, Brutishdog PS Scope. Oh, okay. Sorry. I see what you mean. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Let me see. Brutishdog PS. Right. Okay. Coming in March. Okay. So it's going to be the same kit as this, except that it has parts for the cockpit and pilot inside, essentially. That's pretty cool. Nice. It looks like the inside of the head is also more detailed. No, it's just the painted images. It's just really nicely painted in the sample images here that are online. Huh. Okay. Interesting. Don't know if I'll be picking that up just because I like these kits, but I'm not that much into Scope Dog that I feel like I need to buy every single one that comes out. Like, if I already have the Brutishdog, buying another one just to have one that has the cockpit in it, I feel like maybe not. But for any of you guys, if you're interested, you want one that has the cockpit detail and pilot inside. Let's just, while we're here, cut out our polycaps for the other arm. And PC 5 and 6. The 135th scale Botam's kits are a little too small for me, Machine said. Yeah, they're definitely small. That's why I was saying they're more comparable to Machine and Krieger kits, in my opinion, just because of they're kind of small. And although, as I keep saying, you don't really need to glue them, everything is kind of snap fit, I would recommend gluing them. Whereas I've not actually built one of the 120 scale kits from Bandai, but I imagine just because it's in a larger scale and because it's from Bandai, they're probably much more solid kits. And they probably feel more like building kind of a regular Bandai mecha model kit. So I should build one at some point just to have that comparison in mind. But yeah, I can at least assume as to what they're like. I always kind of thought about getting one, but just I never got around to it. And usually I was like, the ones that are available are not ones that I would prefer, just design-wise. There are some cool designs, but it just seems like the anytime I see them, it's not the one that I want or something, I don't know. Bandai 120 scale kits are definitely more solid, if I remember right. There's a gimmick where you put some of the rivets in for the armor. Oh yeah, that's cool. I think I have seen that as well. PC 31. I think I do also remember seeing that about those kits. To get me almost forgot this other claw piece here. There we go. The claws on this always remind me of a Tremor, like the monster from Tremors movies. Always looked kind of similar to that. My opinion. Get in there. There's that. This little ammo clip goes out the side. That. Uh-oh. Oh, no. This part's not supposed to be there. That goes with the other arm. Okay. And then this here. Should have saved this part for last, seeing as how it's like the signature part of the Brutishdog, the arm. Alright. There you go. Definitely going to have a seam line there on the shoulders. I mean, that's one of the, I don't say many, because it actually doesn't have like loads of seam lines on it, but there's a few seam lines, of course, here and there. That one on the shoulder should not be surprising. Gotta get that pushed all the way onto there. And yeah, the head is always kind of a little bit loosey-goosey, but there we go. The Graboids from Tremor. Yes, exactly. Tremorous. Greetings, everyone. I finally catch live stream. Hey, how's it going? Haven't seen Tremors in ages. Good movie, though. Yeah. I mean, classic. The first three, all like pretty solid in my opinion, I guess. I'm trying to remember what happened in the third one. I remember the first two well enough. The second one was when they had the little ones that like walked around. And the third one, I think, is when they introduced the flying ones, but I don't remember that movie very well. I remember in the second one, there was a scene where like they find like the aftermath of an attack where, and I can't remember too clearly, it was like some guy, third had the ass blasters that flew, yeah. Which those, the flying tremors remind me a lot of, sorry to kind of bounce back and forth, but those ones remind me a lot of the flying monsters in The Mist, if you guys ever saw that movie. Very similar, just like design, and obviously just because they're both like flying monsters, it's easy to draw that similarity between the two. Anyway, PC4. Yeah, there was this scene in Tremors 2 where they find like a guy, or I guess not a guy, a guy's hands, like it's like the hands are like the rest of his body is like all gone, but all that's left is like the hands like holding onto the truck, something like that, on like the back end of the truck. Am I correct in remembering that scene? That's Tremors 2, I believe. But I saw that like when I was over at a friend's house or something, like it was on TV, and when I was too young to see, like I didn't, it was before I watched movies like that. Anyway, I was too young to have seen that and kind of scarred me, I guess. Like it wasn't like something that, you know, caused me to have nightmares every day for the rest of my life after I saw that, but like it scared me. I don't know. Or like it just stuck in my head. It wasn't something that like I saw it on TV and then I ran home crying. But like I just always remembered that scene. One of those things that kind of happens, I think, when you see stuff like that when you're too young, that stuff just kind of sticks with you. And that's a particular scene that I always kind of remember about that movie. There's a Tremors movie where they are in the Arctic. I don't think I've seen that one. I know that there was a more recent one that I think was like a Netflix movie or something, right? Netflix or Amazon or something. I've not watched it yet, but I've just kind of seen the trailers and I've seen ads for it and stuff that I think came out like 1 or 2 years ago. All right. Hands for this guy. Gunpla helps with past movie trauma. Yeah, well, maybe. It can try. And I guess I better refer to the instructions here. So let's see. No, I think that was the right thumb. That this goes into here. Yeah, that's right. And onto there. Probably only need this closed fist, although we do have a couple of hand options. Just that we have... Oh yeah, there is another hand option, I guess I should say, but it's like a holding hand here. I can remember how this goes together. Yeah. You have to put... Okay, yeah. This one was weird because you have... there's nothing to hold, so I'm just going to put in just the... Maybe just a straight one. You have different wrist parts. To be able to change the angle of the wrist, rather than it being a joint, you have just different parts, which you can swap out. And it's a very weird system. So like, you, if you want to change the angle of the wrist, you have to disassemble the entire hand. Just kind of weird, but I guess it's made with the intention that you're going to build it in a particular way and leave it like that. Right, again, as a model kit. So that was, I guess, the reasoning behind that. But so that's our hand option part there. I'm gonna chuck that back in the box for right now. Let's keep our closed fist on there. All right. And let's move on to the legs. Does the Votoms come with a pilot? Oh, no. So, cool DJ Chic one. We were talking about that earlier. There is a version of this that's coming out, the PS version, that comes with parts for the cockpit and pilot inside. But this version does not. Pick up that one if that's something that matters to you. So that one's coming out in March, I said, according to what I just checked online a minute ago. Okay. That last little piece out of there. It's still cool. Yeah. Yeah, it's still cool. Mm-hmm. All right, let's see. PC 11, 7, 17. 11, 7, 17, eh? About this beforehand, I normally don't remove the polycaps ahead of time for these live builds. Oops. Wait a minute. Ah, okay. Because like with the Bandai kit, whatever, you can just twist the polycaps off the runner like quite simply and easily and quickly. You really don't need to cut them off the runner. But with wave kits, I think kind of in general, and especially with this one, obviously, they're a little bit tougher. The plastic's a little bit harder, I guess. So you probably maybe could just twist them off the runner like with the Bandai kit, but kind of easier to just cut them off. So I should have just done that ahead of time. Apologies. Anyway. All right. Leg. Do any of the Bandai Votoms kits come with pilots? I believe they all do. As far as I know, I believe they all at least come with like the cockpit. I mean, the cockpits are like fully there because they're in 120 scale. So I mean, imagine it's larger. So if it's in that large a scale, they should at least have like all of cockpit detail inside of there. If Bandai puts like cockpit detail into their 144 scale Gunpla, then they should on a 120 scale Votoms kit. As far as if they come with pilots, I believe they all come with pilot figures, yeah. But what I don't know, and maybe one of you guys can answer in the chat, on the 120 scale kits from Bandai, are the included pilot figures like soft plastic, like the old 120 scale pilot figures that used to be included with Bandai Master Grades? Or are they hard plastic or resin? I'm sure they're not resin. They're either hard plastic or soft plastic, I would guess. But let me know. I'm curious about that. I'm going to guess they're soft plastic, like what they did with the Master Grade ones. But I'm not sure, actually. I have a wave scope dog that had a super fragile plastic, had to glue it together. Yeah, that's what I was saying earlier too, is that yeah, the kit is technically snap fit and you don't really need to use glue, but yeah, I would just recommend gluing a lot of stuff because for the moment I'm making it without glue just because I like to be able to do the reviews for you guys without gluing. But yeah, definitely when it comes time to actually paint the kit, definitely we'll do that. Let's see. Yeah. That's not right. Here it is. Like that. And this one goes on the other side. There we go. That's why that was kind of not fitting on there properly. That's there. That's, yeah, in there. And here. Oh, quite a lot going on there just in the foot. Mushinen said, if I remember right, they are similar to the old MG pilot figures. Yeah. The body comes in two halves with separate arms and heads. Then you get a sitting body for the cockpit posing, all one color though. Yeah, I'm sure there's probably photos on Dalong as well. I don't know if he has photos like for all of the releases, but I would imagine he probably has photos for at least a couple of the Bandai Scope Dogs kits. So you could probably find that on there if you're interested. I want to do this just because I'm cutting out the polycap parts for the leg for both legs at the same time. Just want to make sure that I'm not having to like guess and test which one is the right polycap for different sections. I'm going to pause that leg and go over to the other leg, build that section, and then kind of go back. Just because otherwise, then I've got like, if I have all the polycaps out all at once, because a lot of them look similar and they're just like, just barely slightly different in size or shape, I don't want to end up getting any of them mixed up. That's the other reason why I don't cut out polycaps ahead of time on a lot of Bandai kits, is that if you have a leg where there's like four, five, six different polycaps that are used on the leg, and a couple of them will be very similar but slightly different in size, then when you're actually going to put it together, you might put the wrong polycap in the wrong place or something like that. So it's another reason why I cut out the polycaps while I'm building, not ahead of time, just so I don't forget which one goes where exactly. The parts are easy enough to figure out if you're putting something in the right place or not. Especially with Bandai kits, they're pretty good about engineering their kits in a way that if you're trying to put a part on in the wrong place, like it won't even go, it like just won't even fit. You'll know right away if it's something wrong. Is it pointing up or down? Okay. I never cut out caps until I need to assemble, yeah, especially if I'm commissioned into customs, yeah. Usually something that I just wait till the end. It's just that for live streaming purposes, it's usually fine that I can just twist them off the runner really fast and easy. I just don't like to have to do something like that during a live stream. Just that's why I prep all the parts ahead of time, just so that you guys watching don't have to watch me just like taking parts off the runner. You can just putting stuff together is the more interesting part of the building process. Just cutting stuff off the runner is even more boring than just sitting here listening to me talking about stuff. So yeah, let's see, we need 19 and 21. The other thing is that it can be kind of difficult to know which polycap is right for a kit like this, just because on Bandai, with Bandai kits, usually if there's two polycaps or more of the same, like the polycap is exactly the same polycap, then they'll all be labeled exactly the same. So they'd be like polycap E, and all the ones that are exactly the same will all be E. Whereas with this, these basically like five or six polycaps all here in a row on this one, which I'm sure, at least as far as I can tell, look exactly the same, but because they're numbered 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, I can't be sure they're exactly the same, and just in case, I don't want to mix them up. So that's kind of annoying. I wish that if they were in fact the same, that they would just be all marked with the same number or letter or whatever. Just kind of takes some of the where'd that piece go? Flashlight. Way back there. Takes the mystery out of it when Bandai labels stuff that are all the same. Christopher asks, would you recommend this kit? Yes, if you like what you see. That's the important part of doing live builds and reviews, is to give you guys an opportunity to see the kit, and if you like what you see, then yeah, I would recommend it. I like it well enough for what it is. I understand it's not going to appeal to everyone, because it's, as we've been talking about, it's more expensive. Like for what you get with it, it's more expensive than just like a Bandai Gunpla kit. But if you like it and you know what you're getting yourself into, I think you'll be happy enough with it. So checking out the live stream, and then later when I do the review, checking out the review should help you decide if it's worth it to you. Would I recommend it? Which is your question, I guess, technically. I would recommend it for anyone who's a Scope Dog fan, who likes smaller scale kits. Smaller size kits, I guess I should say. And if you think it looks cool, then yeah, I would recommend it. It's kind of a lot of parts here going into this one section of the lower leg here. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and two polycaps. 10, and then this knee piece that goes on the front, 11, and then this bar piece that goes around that, 12. Parts there for just the lower leg section. Okay, and then for our knee joint, can tell that polycap's gonna turn on me. I can get this into here. Come on, you. there. Oof, don't want to stress that little piece there too. Come on. I think if I remember correctly, what I did for this part on the other kits was I actually drilled out this part of the kit a little bit, the poly caps, just because this was really tight. There we go. There's one end. And should not forget this part. There we go. Just getting it into there, into the polycap, was a little tough. Less so with the foot, fortunately. There we go. There's our leg. Whew. Now we can finish up the other leg. Already cut that. Okay. All right. No, that's 12 parts for the lower leg. And then another, let's see. For all the leg, 12 plus 1, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, plus a couple more polycaps in there. So over 30. Been building quite a few small boys as of late. Yeah. What else did I build as of late, Chris? I built that. What did I build? Oh, yeah, the Dougram as well. Right. That was also pretty small. Not the Dougram. The Dragonar also starts with a D. Right. But yes, the Dragonar was quite small too. Yeah, wasn't it? Not the Zeta Plus, though. That was relatively big anyway. Not that big. It was a 1/100 scale master grade. So, yeah. But, yeah. Small boys. What's going on, Chris? Yeah. I don't know. So, I don't know what the next live build is going to be, to your point. And maybe it should be something big, I guess. I don't know. Don't know what the next one will be. But, oh, actually, I take that back. I think what the next one might be, I'm not totally decided on this, but I was just thinking about this last night, or yesterday. I think what the next one might be would be the new version of the Megami Device AUV Susanoo Sawan. I was thinking about doing a poll. Although I think if I do a poll and ask people which they would prefer between a Megami Device kit and anything else, I feel like whatever else is on there is probably going to win that poll. Because I know there is a portion of my audience that does like the Megami Device, Mecha Musume type of reviews, but I know it's not everyone. And I think there's probably a lot of more people that just like the mecha models. Fair enough, but I don't know, we'll see. I know that the Susanoo is a very popular Megami device, and it's a new version that I'm getting quite early. I think it's either not out yet in Japan or it's just released. I don't even think I've seen anything about it on Twitter yet. So usually a kit like that, as soon as it's released, I'm seeing all the Japanese builders are already posting about it straight away as soon as it's released. But that one, I don't think I've seen anything about it yet. So I may have got that a couple days early, I think. But I've got it. And it's two nights ago, I went through and cut out all the parts and everything for it. So it's ready. Well, no, I shouldn't say that. It's partly ready. I still have to now go through and remove all the nubs and everything to get it fully ready for putting together. But I thought that because I know that's a pretty popular design, I thought maybe some people will want to see a live build of that one. Maybe I'll put a poll out for it. But yeah, and just before all that, well, at least before I do a live stream or not, at the very least, I need to finish getting all the parts and everything cut out, which that in and of itself is going to take quite a while. Man, this is annoying. There we go. To get this knee part plugged into the polycaps is pretty tough. Yeah. Ouch. Come on, you. I've seen several of them snapped on Twitter already. Oh, okay. So maybe it must be released. Yeah, I think I got it like on release day, basically, or like one day after. I got it directly from Kotobukiya, so I wasn't sure if they sent it earlier or not. I guess maybe sent out early, but I got it once it was actually officially released. I have the OG Susano, the blue flame motif isn't my thing, but I welcome more variants. Yeah, pushing it, to be honest, I was kind of thinking the same thing. Like when I first saw it, I was like, wasn't that into the motif of it. But of course, you know, if Kotobukiya is going to send it to me for review, I'll gladly say absolutely and check it out, because yeah, sure, why not? It's an awesome kit either way. Even though I definitely prefer the aesthetic of the original one, yeah, between the two. But it's quite an impressive kit either way, just because of like all the stuff. Just got a bunch of stuff, right? Let's see. I just spent 2.5 weeks on the MG double Zeta legs and feet, and I've pooped. Yeah, I know. I can imagine, Chris. And I hope that maybe next week I can paint something. I want to paint this frame arms kit bash that I've been working on. Don't really know why we're putting this peg into here before putting anything in the opposite side to hold the polycap in place. Kind of a strange way to go about that, but alright. Okay. So anyway, there's that. Oh yes, I remember this. Yeah, this was tricky. So to get all of this like skirt armor on there, how it shows to do it is to, let's see, I'll make sure I'm putting it on the right way. To put it like this, and then put this bottom part up from the bottom, but like that means you kind of have to really very very carefully balance this part so that the skirt armor doesn't fall off. So I find it much easier to just lay this down, just put it upside down, so it's like less balancing involved. But then you have to make sure that the parts are on. I ended up putting a couple of these so the skirt armor was, because I'm now looking at the instructions, basically I'm looking at it upside down from how it appears in the instructions, so I had to make sure that it on there the right way. There we go. Da-da-da. And while that's like that, let's go ahead and, well, let's put this part on here first. Okay. You're also sick. Yeah, I hope you feel better, Chris. What are you sick with? Probably nothing too serious. Oof. Close all that up, put that there on the front, stick this around here on the back. this adorable little tiny short stubby legs, just because of like the proportions of the scope dog, in this case the British dog, but just the scope dog in general. I mean, like, building it, it feels like it's an SD kit just because of the tiny little stubby legs. But that's just how it goes. See, that's L. Left side and right side are different. I don't know. I feel like I don't know what's actually, I don't know why they made it so that the left and the right side are different. It seems to me that they're exactly the same. Started with the flu, ending this week with the cold. Things are looking up. Oh, yeah, that's no good. Sending the Rosazulu right now, so many hard to sand areas. Yeah, I can imagine. So if you're really trying to sand like every little nook and cranny of that, then yeah, maybe, yeah. Just hearing about the Rosazulu reminds me of another project that I would love to work on. Don't know if and when I'm gonna have the time to get to it, but yeah, the Rosazulu conversion kit, the resin kit. I don't know, fingers crossed. There's that, and this extra bit of ammo that fits in here into the backpack, just like sticks out of there like that. And this fits in place on the back like that. Cute little backpack. Let me show you guys closer up. See, I mean, there's lots of great detail on there. But yeah, this part is the part that's kind of always coming off. This part, because it's made so that you can open it up like that, but it's very loose. It really doesn't want to stay down on there quite well. You like move stuff around, the head just pops off super easily. So these are the kind of things that I would definitely glue, like for painting the kit, for finishing it off. Everything else stays together pretty well, just because there's polycaps in like the arms and legs and everything for the movement of it. And the polycaps help kind of most of the rest of the kit stay together. Whereas with that part of like the head and torso, there's no polycaps in there. So it's just like a little tiny bit of plastic friction that's holding that in there, which is just not really, doesn't really do the job that well. All right, so that's gonna do it for today. What is left in here? These are leftover parts from the regular scope dog kit that are just extra bits, so don't really need that. But I will just toss them back in the box anyway for now. Pretty sure the 83 British dog is Takara, and even Bandai couldn't make something this complex back then. Oh, I'm not sure what you guys are talking about. Let's see if I'm sure that glue on the arm here. Let's see. Of this guy. Oh, yeah, because I wanted to give you guys a size comparison here. Just to wrap up for the day. As it's the perfect time, basically, that we need to wrap up. I'm just gonna tidy up here for a moment. Marie Kondo. I'm sure that it's premature and probably not a good idea. I'm sure the glue has not had enough time to really fully do its job here on this arm piece, but whatever, we're gonna live dangerously just so that I can finish assembling this guy. And I'll just have to remember to be careful with it. There we go. Okay. So for a size comparison between the two, here those are for you guys. And you can see. So yeah, the Scope Dog, even though it's in the larger scale, 1/35th scale and 1/72nd scale, Scope Dog's smaller. And HG Gundam is not something that I have within reach anywhere at the moment. Up there, but it's kind of, yeah. Anyway, this guy is kind of more closer to HG Gundam. The 1/44 scale Gundam would be similar to the Dougram here. That's a small banana for scale. Yes, here. There you go. Here's a knife and nippers for scale. There you go. But that's it for today. Yeah, like it's kind of brightish on there. Anyway, those are still looking good. Yeah, that's it for today, guys. So like I said, I don't know what the next live build will be, if not the Megami device. I think I'll put a poll up, because that's what I'm going to be building next, one way or the other, whether you guys want to see a live stream. So if not, then I'll just build it, and then it'll be just a little bit longer until whenever the next live stream is. But if you want to see that live stream, then I can do that sooner. Probably not on Monday. I probably won't have it ready by Monday, because it's just a lot of parts. I don't think I'll have time to get it all prepped over the weekend. I'll try, but if not that, then it might be one of the Witch from Mercury HGs, actually, or these are a couple of other kits right here that are in the queue. The big gigantic arms Hazel Osla, or MG Astria F-Type. But I don't think you guys probably care too much about seeing a live stream of either one of those kits, do you? I can't imagine. A big P-Bandai kit? Probably not going to be that popular for people to watch, I guess. I don't know. But those are up in the building queue as well, so if not the Megami device kit, the next live stream will be one of those. GFED said make a perfect grade live. Not that, but I do have the HGC Dendrobium on the way, so I'll definitely be live streaming that, but it won't be next. I think hopefully I'll get that like Monday or Tuesday of next week, but then it would be like maybe later in the week, if not the week after that, that I actually kind of start doing the live stream on it, or I'll be sharing that with you guys. But I will be live streaming the building of that kit, I think, as much as I can, just because of the nature and how big that kit is. I think it'll be kind of difficult to do that, but it'd be, if I can manage it, it'd be good content. So I want to try to share as much of that with you guys as I can, just because it's such a unique kit in its size, and I think probably very few people have it, just because it's so big and so expensive, and just because Bandai doesn't make it that often. So it's one that probably doesn't have a whole lot of coverage on YouTube. So if I can cover as much of that as I can, I think that'd be worthwhile, just for people to be able to check out here on YouTube. I would love to see a Lifrith build, get some ideas, since I'm planning to make one as my first painted build. Andres, I wouldn't be building the Lifrith as like a live stream anytime soon, just because I've already built and reviewed it, but it is a kit that I would like to do some sort of customization with, although I haven't really thought too much about it yet. But if and when I ever do like some sort of like custom Witch from Mercury build with the Lifrith or something, obviously I would share that with you guys as like kind of a standard work in progress. But it wouldn't probably be anytime soon. MGSD Freedom is out. When will you get it? I'm not sure. I don't know yet. Hopefully soon, but I'm not sure. So we'll see. Do you have any more finished Machine Krieger kits to show off? Nothing finished, but I've got a couple that are still work in progress. Like I'm still working on the... I did a couple live streams on it, I think, right? Didn't I? Or at least one live stream. Or I think two live streams building the Falke, the 40th anniversary version of the Falke, I've still not finished that. I need to get back to that. I took a break because I thought about making kind of like a bit of like a diorama kind of base for that, even though it's like flying, but sort of like a forced perspective kind of diorama base kind of vignette for the Falke. And I needed the parts for that, and I have the parts for that, but I'm still kind of not totally set on the idea. And I wanted to add a couple of LEDs into that as well, and I have the LED parts for it. So it's just a matter of, I just need to just, it's been sitting under my desk for months, so I just need to bring it out from under the desk onto the desk and finish it and paint it. And yeah, it's yeah, I need to do that. So anyway, that's it for today, guys. I'm going to wrap up the stream. Hope you guys all have a great weekend. I've got the MOOC review video for you guys. I'll set that to post tomorrow morning, like local time, Saturday morning, so that sometime over the weekend, if you guys want to check that out, you can chill out with like a 28, 29 minute long, just look through a quite interesting MOOC. I won't spoil yet what it is, but check it out over the weekend if you guys are keen on that. But yeah, that's going to be it for today. And I'll see you guys next week. Bye-bye.